right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive studio. And joining me now is Brandon Macdonald, the CEO of Fireweed Zinc. And Brandon, welcome back. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing very well, thanks. How about you?
Doing well, thank you. So you finished off your 2020 season. You're done. Let's take a step back. Obviously, I found it interesting that you used the term short but intense season this year. Obviously, yeah, with what we're facing with COVID. Tell me about the short but intense season.
Well, we had to start a lot later than normal. You know, the market for financings, which enabled this drill season, really wasn't healthy until July. So we had the money in the bank to kick this off really only at the very beginning of August and had things, you know, ramping up right around then. And then right now, there's around the time of year, we're getting wintered out, right? You know, we're able to operate in pretty cold conditions, but it's not a truly, truly winterized camp. So by the time it's starting to approach minus 15, minus 20, it's time to pack our bags and leave. So it was a lot to get done in a short period of time.
So you were able to get a total of 10, diamond drill holes in there. So what was the philosophy for this drill season?
It was all about boundary zone. You know, 9 of the 10 holes were there. We were thinking of doing more in the broader area, but as soon as we delineated that gravity anomaly around boundary, we knew that we had to test it and we had to, you know, do our best to scale the opportunity, so to speak, there. And then we took that and did one more drill hole at the 240 mile target, which unfortunately seems the gravity anomaly there was not what we thought, but we didn't hit the prospective horizon there. So it's a bit weird. It's like we left the hole open. We might revisit it next year. But by the time we got down to 600 plus meters, without hitting the prospective horizon at Tom and Jason and with the weather getting colder, we decided, look, this is perhaps a project for 2021.
Now, even though the drilling part, there is a couple of other things that are going on right now there. You've got a couple of leftover things that you're just getting the crews to do right now. Is that right?
Yeah. So finishing up the core cutting and logging, some geophysics, stuff like that we're just wrapping up, mm-hmm. and then we're going to get out of there.
Yeah. Let's talk about next year. Obviously, you've, you know, I know it's hard to look for next year because we're still in this pandemic, but ideally to get back, when do you hope to get back on there? And what will be the focus then for 2021? Have you thought that far ahead yet, or are you waiting to see what the results are from the drilling this year?
No, we've definitely thought that far ahead. So one of the things we did is we're leaving one of the drills on site over winter. And we have trucks and a bulldozer and a bunch of equipment there. We have 60,000 liters of fuel on site to be there over winter. So that's going to give us the opportunity to start the drill season a little bit earlier than we normally would. Normally, we have to wait for the road to be reopened, which is early June, before we start bringing in heavy equipment and drills and fuel. Now we can get started before that. So we're potentially thinking a late April, early May start next year. And it's pretty clear the task before us, funding, you know, it's obviously a question, but if we get the funding, you know, we want to drill off boundary to at least an inferred resource and get some more drilling into Tom and Jason, which will feed into a 2022, sort of early 2022, updated global resource and PEA on the project.
Yeah. And just about that funding, are you feeling that just because of where we are in the world as far as this pandemic, it was so delayed, obviously, as you mentioned a little bit earlier, do you feel that might be easier this year? I know funding's never easy, but you think it might be a little easier to at least have meetings and things like that, talk to people about the funding?
Yeah, you know, and it is going to be easier. And it's a big, hungry project. You know, in our share price performance this year, having, you know, tripled off our March lows, gives us a market cap to work with that will make it easier to raise money. You know, it's hard to raise $15 million when your market cap is $15 million. Not so hard to raise $15 million when your market cap is 60 as it is now. So I think, you know, knock on wood, nothing is a given in this industry, and certainly these markets are hyper volatile, but we're feeling pretty positive about our chance to have a very large funding package for work next year.
All right, sounds good. Well, we look forward to hearing the results when those assays are back from the lab. So, Brandon, great to see you again. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you very much.
All right, Brandon Macdonald, the CEO of Fireweed Zinc.